boy. Today, I'm gonna go ahead and make some stuffed potatoes, and I'm gonna use that beef bourguignon that I made the other day to stuff inside the potatoes, because it had no potatoes in it. It was supposed to have parsnips, but I ain't had none. I used carrots instead. The hell with it. I want to clarify something on the gumbo and a lot of Cajun cooking in general. Everybody down here in Louisiana knows how to cook, and I'm sure a lot of people in other parts of the world and country know how to cook too. And unless you just eating McDonald's every day. Anyway, the gumbo. Everybody's mama and grandma makes a gumbo. Okay? Everybody's mama's and grandma's gumbo is better than the next person's gumbo. And it's normally better than restaurant gumbos, number one, because the restaurants can't afford to make enough profit margin by putting as much seafood or meat or whatever in the gumbo. It's the same way with other dishes that, say, I make down here. I put more stuff in it where restaurants tend to try to cut corners. Now, there are some exceptions to that rule, but that's far few and in between. And if you want a restaurant like that, you're going to pay through the ass for a dish. Like, I think a good 2 gallons of gumbo cost me about $32 to make, whereas the restaurant's going to cut corners. And they're going to probably try to make it for around $10 or $15, half price. Because they're cutting back on the cost of the ingredients to pay the staff and just everything like that. So, I wanted to clarify that. So I'm going to bake me a potato. Miss JV got to get Christmas shopping done, so she's going to eat it tomorrow in the food court. And they got food courts in the mall down here too. And they cook pretty damn good for a decent price. It's better than eating at Mickey D's or some other fast food joint. So I'm gonna bake a potato and reheat some of that beef bourguignon. The beef stew with wine and butter and bacon. And I'll put that on top of a baked potato. Yum, boy. So I got me a big baked potato, or a big potato ready to be baked. First thing I'm gonna do is wash it and scrub it real good. Here's an iPhone so you can see how big that tater is in comparison. So let me get it washed and we're gonna start it baking off in the oven. All right, boy, look. If you really scrub the pith out of the potato, you need the skins. But you got to get all that dirt off of them. You want a stiff brush, which I got. And the skin has got a lot of vitamins in it. And minerals and dirt. But you got to clean all that off really, really good. And then you go bake it off and you can eat that skin. And it's good for you, boy. All right? Let me get done with this. All right, boy. So we got us a baked potato right there. Hot potato. Hot, hot, hot. Look right there. Let's cut that open. Hot potato, hot potato, hot, hot, hot. I don't know if you heard that skin But it's crispy, crispy. Alright? Ooh, yeah, baby. Hot potato, hot potato. Cut him open. Now here's that beef up bourguignon that I took and reduced down a little bit. And we're going to pour that on top of that tater and eat that sucker. So here we go. You don't need no butter. You don't need no sour cream. Because the beef up bourguignon, look, just pour it all up on that. It got all the fat in there you want right now. Whatever. Drag all of that out of there. You want to garnish it and make it look pretty? Do that. Look, here's some chives out of my garden. Snip some of them on top. God damn it. Now. Just throw them on there, boy. Who cares? Eat that. Now, garnish. Now, you know y'all trying to eat healthy. So look here. I steamed some broccoli in one of them little steamer bags. Now, eat that too. How about that? Oh no. Oh no, JB. Don't put no sour cream on there. Bullshit. Sour cream. Probably some more. Now, eat that. It's good for you.